children, today in our science class we'll see the last unit of our first term, that is science in everyday life. So in our day-to-day life we have science. Each and every minute in our life is dependent on science only, and the technologies was improved a lot. So if you compare the life of your parents and yours now, it is different. So in their lifetime, you see, it will be different, and now it is in advance. Okay, so and if you compare with your grandparents and parents, it will also differs. Okay, so not the same. It is changing day by day. The technologies are improving day by day. The science is improved day by day. Okay children, so that is what we are going to learn in this lesson. Okay, so I'm about few scientists from Tamil Nadu. In this lesson we are going to see as the first part, and in today's class we are going to see about few scientists who is from Tamil Nadu. Okay, so science has helped us to find solution to many of our problems. It has shaped our life, daily life also. The world we are living in is not the same as before. It is changing every day, in fact, every hour. We see lot of changes around us. Day by day, it is changing a lot. Yes, our children. So some of them are reversible and some of them are irreversible. Irreversible changes like burning of waste pollute our home and school environment. So we need to know about waste management and proper disposal of waste. So let us study about them in this lesson. So about these things we have seen last year itself, about waste management and proper disposal in our first term, I think. So we have learnt already, yes or no children? So now the first topic of this unit, scientist from Tamil Nadu. So in Tamil Nadu there are many scientists like Subramanian Chandrasekhar, Venkat Raman, Ramakrishnan, Sir C.V. Raman, A.P.J. Abdul Kalam, Srinivas Ramanujam, M.S. Swaminathan. So all these persons are, etc. All these persons are scientists from Tamil Nadu. So Tamil Nadu has a long history of science since ancient times. Scientific concepts can be seen in ancient Tamil literatures. Tamil Nadu has produced many scientists who have contributed to the world of science. The following table gives the names of some of the scientists from Tamil Nadu and their contributions. So what are the scientists na? So the name of the scientist, department and contribution is given. Dr. M.S. Swaminathan, he is under the department of genetics and he contributed Green Revolution. Srinivas Ramanujam in the department of mathematics, he contributed composite numbers. The name of the scientist, Venkat Raman Radhakrishnan, biology, structure of ribosomes. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, aeronautical engineer, missile development. Sir C.V. Raman, physics, scattering of light. So in this lesson we are going to see the history of Sir C.V. Raman and APJ Abdul Kalam. Okay children, so first we'll see about Sir C.V. Raman. So he was born, his name, full name is Sir Chandrasekhar Venkata Raman. He was born on 7th November 1888. He was an Indian physicist. He works in the field of scattering of light. He won Nobel Prize in Physics in the year 1930. He got Bharat Ratna Award in the year 1954 and he got Lenin Peace Prize in the year 1957. So see, Chandrasekhara Venkata Raman was born at Trichurapalli, Tamil Nadu on 7th November 1888. In 1904, he completed his Bachelor of Arts, that is BA degree, at Presidency College, Chennai. He stood first and won gold medal in physics. In 1907, he got his Master of Science MSc degree from University of Madras. Sir C.V. Raman won the Nobel Prize in Physics in the year 1930 for his work in scattering of light. In 1954, he was awarded the Bharat Ratna. Okay, these are the awards he got and this is the history of Sir C.V. Raman. And coming to his findings, okay, his contribution, scattering of light. So, he has found why the sky is appearing blue in color most of the time. So, why it is so, na? The gases and particles in Earth atmosphere scatter sunlight in all the directions, children. So, because of that, the blue light is scattered more than the other colors because it travels as short and smaller waves. It will have smaller waves. So, it will be scattered more. So, that is why we see a blue sky most of the time. Clear? That is what he found. And one day in the summer of 1921, Sir C.V. Raman was on the deck of a ship sailing in the Mediterranean Sea. He was observing the blue color of the sky and started reasoning it. He concluded that sunlight is scattered by the gases and particles present in the air. The white light we see is composed of different colors such as your rainbow colors. So, vibgyar. So, violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red. Among these colors, blue is scattered more. Because of this reason, sky appears blue most of the time. So, during sunrise and sunset, it will be red color. Yes or no? So, because the rays of red color will be traveling long distance. So, during sunrise and sunset, rays have to travel long distance. As they travel, all the other colors except red are scattered. So, sky appears red at sunrise and sunset. So, the rest of the time, it will be in blue color. Okay, children? Then, coming to Abdul Kalam. APJ Abdul Kalam. So, we all know about him. He is our former president of India. His full name is Aul Pakir Jainulabdin Abdul Kalam. And he was born on 15th October 1931 at Rameshwaram. So, he is an Indian aerospace scientist. He did his studies in St. Joseph College, Trichy and also in Madras Institute of Technology. And he wrote a few books like Wings of Fire, India 2020, Ignited Minds, Indomitable Spirit, etc. And he got prizes also, like Bharat Ratna Award, Padma Bhushan, Padma Vibhushan, Bharat Ratna, etc. all he got. And he worked a lot in our lifetime. So, Aul Pakir Jainulabdin Abdul Kalam was an aeronautical scientist. He was born on 15th October 1931 in Rameshwaram, Tamil Nadu. He got his Bachelor of Science, BSc degree from Saint Joseph College, Trichrapalli, in 1954. In 1960, he got his degree in aeronautical engineering from Madras Institute of Technology. He was involved in India's missile development program and thus came to be known as Missile Man of India. He also served as the President of India, and he is the only People's President. Yes or no, children? And widely referred to as the People's President. He is so simple and a humble person, we can say. Yes. He was awarded Padma Bhushan in 1981, Padma Vibhushan in 1990, and Bharat Ratna in 1997. He has written many books like Wings of Fire, India 2020, and Ignited Minds. So this is all about these two scientist children. So in the next class, we'll see about the next topic. Okay, thank you.